If you've ever inherited a project and the code is kind of a mess, this tutorial is for you. I'm going to show you how you can use the standard gem to reformat this code to be something a bit more consistent. And I'm also going to show you how you can use a GitHub action to run the linter against any new code coming into your code base, which will just stop this kind of ugly code ever reaching your code base again. Let's jump in. Standard is a Ruby gem written on top of RuboCop, which is a really common linter and code formatter for Ruby. However, they've set it up with some really nice defaults, which mean like you just don't need to configure it or tweak it. You can just run it as is. If it can make your code better, it will. If it can't, it just generally doesn't complain about it unless it's a security issue, which is really nice. To get using it on your project, you just add standard to your gem file. And then you get access to the standard rb command. So I've gone ahead and added it to my gem file already, which is quite cool. And we're going to take this post model here. We can see there's a few things wrong with it. It's using single quotes here and double quotes up here. This method looks a bit funny. There's some odd spacing going on here. Like this generally, it's not perfect. It's not something you'd really want to pick up daily. So let's quickly go to terminal. I'm going to run bundle exec standard rb, and I'm just going to drop the file name in for now because it's going to tell us everything it wants to change. So let's go through and have a look. There we go. We can see it said, oh, here's all the things I found which I can fix. And it's even said, hey, if you want to fix these automatically, just pass in that flag. So we're going to do that. There you go. And it's just going to fix that file for us. It's now nice and like consistent. We can obviously tidy it up a little bit more. I'd probably just do that. But you know, that's no biggie. That's nice and easy to fix. But look at that improvement. And all we had to do was just run one command. That's really good. Using this in terminal is cool, but I quite like having this integrated with my editor. And most editors will support standard. You've just got to find the configuration for you. In Vim, I've got it set up here, so if there is a mistake on a line, it will just kind of warn me at the bottom here. And I have a hotkey to just auto fix the file. In most of my projects, I have it now set up, so every time I push to GitHub, it will just run standard RB against the whole code base, which is really fantastic. I want to quickly show you what that looks like. I have a real life project here called Spotify Daily Shuffle. It shuffles playlists on Spotify every day for my Amazon speaker. I've created a new branch. I'm just going to quickly go into this model. I'm going to check a raise foobar in here. I'm also going to mess with this formatting, and yeah, I'm just going to like chuck this like 9 columns over. That's good enough. Cool. So yeah. You can see there's definitely some stuff which is going to trigger the linter, so let's commit that up. Showing off standard GitHub action. Just gonna push that up. Okie dokie, so that's now been pushed up. And if I was to quickly create a pull request, do that now. Can see it's running here. It's been queued to just quickly double check what's going on, make sure the code looks good. Let's see, let's kind of have a look and see what's happening here. So it takes just a moment to install the gems, but that only takes a few seconds. And you can see it's just failed here because it has some unreachable code and the formatting's a bit wrong on that playlist model file, which is what's wrong. So what's really cool about this is that'll make it harder for someone to merge this code if it's not valid, which I absolutely love. I think that's like exactly how it should be. It's like, hey, your code's not good enough. If you just run this auto fixer, it'll fix it. But you know, see what happens. If you want to run this in your own projects, what you need to do is add a .github folder and workflows as another folder, and then this standard.yaml, and just copy this in. And it should kind of work out the bat, so that's quite cool. You can find this in my Docker Rails template. I'm going to link to it in the show notes below, so don't worry about having to go search this or type this up. So that is standard in a bit of a nutshell, which I love this gem so much. It's one of those gems. I started using it on my projects and everything just got better. The code got more consistent. It started warning me about like silly little mistakes, and I just became more confident as a developer as a result. So I'd really encourage everyone to give this one a look. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe below. Like, that's always important. And also maybe give me a follow on Twitter. I love seeing what everyone is like kind of up to and chatting to everyone who watches these videos. So it's always good. So thank you so much, and I'll see you on the next episode.